inside, it looks pretty good.
At Paradise Hill, Tony Beats is waiting for frozen pay dirt in his two main cuts to thaw. To keep the gold coming in, he's making a smash and grab in one of his piggy banks, the swallow cut.
You know, this kind of a around little cut, it's kind of nice to get it set up by myself. I'm very positive that there's very decent gold in there. Now we put somebody else in there, and then they can clean it up.
The Trommel is being loaded with 300 yards of pay from the swallow cut every hour.
That's not a good noise. Let's turn that thing off, because that is loud. Ugh, that sounds horrible. Hey, Tony, got a copy. Tony? I think the gearbox and the conveyor is on the way out.
Tell me the thing is dead.
The gearbox turns the conveyor belt, which delivers the pay into the wash plant.
If you got a spare, we can swap it out.
Okay, good enough. Just gotta go and fix it.
Pretty much ASP.
For the second time in a week, Tony's only moneymaker is shut down.
I mean, it kind of sucks that we're gonna have to change that gearbox out, but if we don't do it now, it's gonna grenade. I mean, it's the height of summer. Let's not around.
The Beats have a spare gearbox. It should be an easy swap.
This gearbox doesn't work. I mean, like anything with the Trommel, I don't want to have to come back and do it twice. So that's why we're going to replace it with a new one that we know is good.
To fit the new gearbox, Kevin needs to reuse the old bushing.
Let's see if she fits. Do this way. Yeah, that's not gonna work. Ain't no way that's gonna work. Not a chance. We can't put the gearbox on until we have this piece. Without it, everything's down. We're not getting any gold. So that means it'd be a couple days. We lose a lot of sluicing hours that way.
Tony Beats' operation is at a standstill thanks to a broken gearbox.
Where the is it?
But the replacement is missing the right-sized bushing.
Oh, it's all the way down here. Looks like we're S-O-L. Out of luck. Hey, Tony, got a copy. Tony?
Hey, Kevin.
I haven't fixed.
Well, I'm about to put the new gearbox on, and I can't find a spare piece.
Where are you?
Every hour the Trommel is down costs Tony $3,000.
How's it looking, Kevin?
Oh, not having thing is the usual big problem.
I'm on the white horse.
With no spares in his boneyard,
let's go. Girls, bring the pallet, Kevin.
Tony must now make an overnight trip to Whitehorse to pick up the new bushings.
Look at the color on these two. See what you can get out of the person with how fast piss them off. He's even a piss off Mike with a lift. It's amazing.
Hang in there. There you go.
Good. Okay, I'm out of here. Kevin, see you tomorrow night.
Yeah. Somebody calling Kevin?
I think I found the pieces you need.
What's the inner diameter of it?
1.5.
Cool. Make sure Tony doesn't leave. I'm coming to the yard.
Tony, copy Tony.
We might be lucky.
Faith catches Tony just in time for Kevin to retrieve the gearbox.
Yeah. Okay, those look right. Sweet. Okay. Perfect.
So when I went through my containers, all of a sudden there's this box
Oh my, this is the things that Kevin needs.
Excellent. Okay. Beautiful. Now that we have all the right, we're just putting the new gearbox on.
Roughly there. There we go.
Beautiful. So the Trommel's been down for about 7 hours now. It's a lot of money not to be making, so let's get the on.
Up we go.
Perfect. Once everything's on the shaft, I gotta tighten everything up, make sure everything lines up.
Then I think we just gotta fill it with oil, and we're giggling.
Time. We fire it right back up.
We gotta have this thing rolling.
Anyway, this goes to show how such a small thing can cut into your goal for the season. At least now the Trommel is rolling again. I don't give a where they find material to sluice. Long as we put something in that box to keep us sluicing to reach our 5,000-ounce goal.
Hi, guys.
Hey, everybody.
Hey, guys.
After a week of frozen ground and shutdowns in the Swallow Cut, Tony Beats is eager to see if his piggy bank will pay out.
Okay, anyway, let's get started over. You, Monica, get going.
Right?
Right.
A little aggressive, unnecessary, but okay.
I feel that.
Anybody ask you?
Yes. So I'm sure you noticed there's not a lot of gold.
I mean, we were down for a bit this week.
How much is a bit?
Well, it must have been quite a bit.
We sluiced about four and a half days.
Yeah, the gearbox for the conveyor going down kind of took a full day and then some.
It was nice that we found that piece, though.
Especially with Tony basically off to Whitehorse at that moment.
Yeah.
Well, you gotta go.
Yeah.
At least I'd save this 2 days of sluicing.
At least.
We should wait at
okay, pour it in there, let's see what we got.
To stay on course for their 5,000-ounce goal, Tony needs his piggy bank to provide 260 ounces.
Ready? Let's do this thing, chicken wings.
10, 40, 60, 70, 78.7.
No, it's dead silence. No wonder if you get that much, I guess. That's all we got out of it, and I guess we're not going back there now, are we?
No.
But not impressive at all, but you have those days too, I guess.
Yeah.
You know, you can't appreciate the good days unless you have a bad day too.
Oh, okay, yeah, listen to that.
A lot of folks would be really happy to have that amount.
I mean, half dirt, half pay dirt, I mean, what do you expect to, right?
This is not gonna do it.
So we'll go back out there and see what we can do there, Mike.
Bye, guys.
Bye.
On the end of the day, it'll come out okay. I mean, as long as we gather 5,000 ounces, we don't give a where it comes from.
Well, only 4,100 or so to go.
Well, that's all right, but I mean, like you say, as long as on the end it evens out, it don't really matter, right?
Sure.
I'll better get out there, I guess.
Bye.
Bye.